Now we are going to discuss question number 5.36, and again this is a question given to you. Listen carefully and try to understand this question. In this question it is given to you, the rear side of a truck is open, clear? So we can say this is a truck and this is the rear side of this truck and this is open, okay, fine. A box of 40 kilogram placed at a 5 meter away from an open end as shown in a figure, clear? So in this situation it is given, let's suppose this box is placed at a distance of 5 meter from the rear end and mass of this block is given to you, this is 40 kg, clear to everyone? Okay, fine. Coefficient of friction between box and the surface is 0.15, so mu value is given 0.15, fine. Now in this question it is given, on a straight road truck start from rest, it means initial velocity of truck is 0 and it accelerate with 2 meter per second square, so acceleration of truck is given 2 meter per second square, clear? So at what distance from the starting point box fall off a truck? Actually in this question the objective is to calculate the total distance covered by the truck before falling this box from this truck, clear? So how can we calculate? A very simple strategy that we will use, because this truck is actually going with some acceleration, this box is placed on this truck, it means we can say this box is in accelerating frame, or we can say this is in non-inertial frame, yes or no? It means I can say, let's suppose if I place observer on this truck, at that time we can say observer will see this box is going in a backward direction because a pseudo force will come into picture, clear? So first I will find here force exerted, or I can say pseudo force that is exerted. So I can say pseudo force exerted, this is given by mass into acceleration. Mass of this block is given to you 40 kg, and acceleration of this block we have 20, so 2 meter per second square, so pseudo force is acting 18 newton, clear? But it is also given here we have coefficient of friction between this box and this truck. It means first we also calculate here limiting friction. So limiting friction is given by mu times of n, value of mu 0.15, and total mass of this block is given 40. So I can take here this is 40 multiplied 10 because this is 40 g, clear? So if I remove this decimal, I can say this one and this one cancelled out. Now 50 multiplied 4, we have 60. So from here you can say limiting friction, you are getting 60 newton. It means if I draw here pseudo force, listen carefully, if I draw, we can say pseudo force will act in this direction, clear? And definitely friction will act in the opposite direction, clear? Now you can see this pseudo force is acting, this is 18 newton, it is greater than compared to limiting friction, this is acting, yes or no? It means we can say definitely net force will act in a backward direction, clear? So now I am writing what is net force acting, clear? So I can say net force acting, this is given by 80 minus 60, and we can say this is equal to 20 newton, clear? So net force acting on this box, this is given by 20 newton, clear? Now it is also given distance between this rear side, this is given to you 5 meter, clear? So can we calculate, because now we know net force acting, we can easily calculate acceleration. Acceleration we can write like this, mass into acceleration, yes or no? Yes or no, clear? Or you can say now because this is net force, we can say acceleration is given by 20 by 40, and this is half of meter per second square, clear? Clear, yes. So now we can see, because acceleration of this block is half, can we calculate total time taken by this block to reach from this end to this end? Yes. So because acceleration is constant, so I can apply here equation of motion. So I am writing here s equal to ut plus half of 80 square, ut plus half of 80 square. Now distance covered by this block is 5 meter, so I can say this is 5, initial velocity we have 0, plus we can say 1 by 2, acceleration is half, and total time taken we have to find, clear? So we can write like this, because this is t square, so I can say this is 2 multiplied 2, this is 4, so t square we can say this is 5 multiply 4. Clear everyone? Yes. Now, can we write here total distance covered by this truck? Yes. Again, we can apply this equation of motion, s equal to ut plus half of at square. Yes. S value we have to calculate. Initial, this truck is at rest. And 1 by 2. Acceleration of this truck we have. This is 2. Clear? And what is total time taken? We can say, I can write here 5 multiply 4. Clear? So, we can say this one and this one cancel out. And from here, we can say 20 meter. So, directly we can say total distance covered by this truck before. This block actually, it actually going out of a truck. We can say this is equal to 20 meter. Clear? So, this is all about this question.